so much for coming over to our YouTube page. Today we're going to be doing a tutorial on how to make some really fun and really, really simple cupcakes. All of the ingredients and the equipment that you need is listed underneath the video, and I also posted it on my Instagram page. So as soon as I put this little monster to bed, we can get started. See you in a sec. Right, so this recipe is really, really simple, really straightforward. Pretty much has three bowls of stuff. If you've already looked at the ingredients, then you know roughly what we're going to use, and I'm just going to show you how we whip it together and put it into the oven. So the first thing you need is a mixing bowl, either with an electric mixer or a hand mixer. And what we've got in here is the sugar. So just to remind myself, we've got 130 grams of sugar in here, 1 teaspoon of vanilla. And to that, I'm going to add 3 eggs, like medium-sized eggs. So I've got the eggs here. So that's the sugar, the vanilla, and the eggs. So that's going to go in there. And then we're going to start mixing this together. And while that's mixing, you want to get a little bowl and weigh out your flour. So we've got 195 grams of flour, 195, 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder, and 1/4 teaspoon of salt. So that's ready to go in there. And then in a smaller bowl, I've got the milk and the butter. So I've got 113 grams of butter, any kind that's fine, salted or unsalted. And I've got 60 grams of milk, any kind of milk is fine. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna whisk the eggs together a little bit more, add the milk and the butter, and then we're gonna add in flour bit by bit, and then just keep whisking it for another couple of minutes until everything has come together. One thing I should say about the butter and the milk is that you want them both to be liquid consistency. So I've put that in the microwave for about a minute just to melt the butter down. So we're gonna keep mixing this, add the milk and butter, add the flour, and then get them into the kitchen. It's gonna make quite a runny batter. So I have a jug handy, I'm going to pour it into the jug and then use the jug to pour it into the cake tin, or cupcake tin. So I've got my cupcake tray ready with my cases. If you don't have cases, it's not the end of the world. You can just grease each of these cavities really, really well so that the cakes just fall out afterwards. As you can see, this batter makes 9 cupcakes. And I filled my cupcakes to about 3/4 full. You want to go quite high because what we want when they're cooked is a nice dome on the top. So 3/4 of the way full, and I'm going to pop these in the oven, which is already on at 175 for 22 minutes, and then I'm going to check them. To check them, you just want to slightly poke your finger in the middle, and if it doesn't leave a dent and it bounces back, then you know they're done. So my cupcakes are out of the oven and I've just put them aside to cool. So while they're cooling, I just want to show you how to make a really quick and simple buttercream. This is the basis I use for all of my buttercream recipes, and then just add different flavouring into this. So it's 500 grams of icing sugar, which is in this bowl already, and then 1/2 the quantity of that of unsalted butter. So 250 grams of unsalted butter. The butter I've melted down in the microwave for about 30 seconds to 40 seconds, just so that 1/2 of it's liquid. So it's not completely melted, but sort of halfway melted, just so that it mixes in a bit more easily. Don't overheat it, because if you do, you could curdle your buttercream, so you don't want it to be too hot. So I'm going to pop that in there, and grab a towel so it doesn't make a massive mess, and start whisking. Start whisking on a really slow speed. If you go really high, it's going to go all over the place, and all up your nose and in your mouth. So start at low speed and then gradually get higher. And I whisk it for about 2 minutes. Okay, here we go. Okay, so I've finished whisking this, and as you can see, it's a really nice light colour, and it's nice and airy, so that's done. Okay, so now we're ready to start decorating the cake. So I'm going to show you three different types of decoration, and you can pretty much just do whatever you want, use whatever you want to kind of follow the method, but use whatever you want to decorate. So the first one we're going to do is a butterfly. So as you can see, our cupcakes have come out with a nice hump on top, and hopefully yours have too. So the first thing we're going to do is cut that little hump off because we want to use that. So with a knife, and the parent can do this bit, you want to slice off the top of the cupcake, pop it on the chopping board, and then slice it in the middle so that you end up with two halves and you've got a flat top on your cupcake. And then we're going to put some buttercream onto the flat top of the cupcake. So if you wanted to, you could put some flavouring into your buttercream, which is something I don't think I said before. Just pop in some vanilla extract or lemon flavouring or whatever it is that you want. So we're just going to put some buttercream on here. You don't have to use a little spatula like this, you can just use a knife. Look at that, Gigi. Look at that. And then what we're going to do to make the butterfly is, with the two pieces of cake that we've got left over now, we're going to dip these in some jam. I've just mixed this jam up, so we're just going to dip the back part, so the part that was actually exposed when we were cooking it, to make it sticky. Now I mixed this jam up a little bit to get rid of any lumps, so I've dipped the back part in strawberry jam, and I'm going to dip it in some sprinkles. There we go. And then pop it back on my board. And I'm gonna do the same with the other part. And then dip it in the sprinkles. Pop it back on my board. And then we are gonna put it back on the cupcake, but instead of putting it the way that we took it off, we're gonna put it the other way, if that makes any sense. Yeah. So we're gonna go like that to make some butterfly wings. And then I've got some little butterfly centers that I made from fondant, so I'm going to pop those on. You can use anything you've got, you can make them out of anything that you've got. Got a little butterfly head, and I've got the little tentacles. There you go, the butterfly cupcake. So that's one idea, one way to decorate your cupcakes. And I'm going to show you the next one. I'm just going to make sure it's all right there. So for the other two cupcakes, we're going to do something a little bit different to the butterfly. So the first one, we're going to do a little nest, so kind of an Easter theme. So again, with your cupcake, you want to chop the top off because we want to use that. And then what we want to do with the top is actually mix it with some buttercream. Mix that sponge with some buttercream so we can make some little eggs from it. So all you need to do for that is literally break up your sponge, add a bit of the buttercream back in, not too much, just add enough so that you get a nice sort of pliable mixture so you can mould it into little egg shapes. So then just get your hands dirty and give it a mush until it becomes mushy enough to roll into a little ball. Right, so you want to do that until you've got little egg shapes that you can roll, and do about three. And then with the little egg shapes that you've got, you want to roll them around in your jam and then roll them around in the sprinkles to make little sprinkle covered eggs. And then we're going to knead them up and then pop them on top of the cupcake. So I've got a few that I've already made here, so I'm just going to quickly wash my hands. Right, and then to decorate this cupcake, again, we're going to go on with some buttercream at the bottom. Put anything in it, maybe chocolate, grated chocolate, or anything you've got, to make a sort of little nest effect. And then we're going to put the little eggs inside that. So I've got some grated lemon zest, so I'm just going to use that. You might want to take some of this off before somebody eats it, because it could be quite strong. Okay. And then I'm going to pop my little eggs inside. we go. There's your second slightly Eastery themed cupcake. Right, so the third and final cupcake is really easy. It's gonna be an ice cream. So again, I've laid on lots of buttercream this time. And this is really, really easy and simple. And I've got some yummy chocolate sauce. I'm just gonna pour on my chocolate sauce and sprinkles and make it look a bit like an ice cream. So there's my chocolate sauce. And some sprinkles. Make a mess. And then with whatever you can find, I've got some of these. If you've got wafers or anything like that, that would be even better. I'm gonna pop that in there. And that's gonna be my ice cream cupcake, which is the really messy one. And there you go. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, and hopefully you'll get to do loads more of these in the time that we're at home, so you can bake some more with your kids. Thank you so much, bye.